is pretty clear that people's information is available now out on the dark web in a form that is accessible to bad actors.
Now at 6, a cyber attack against the city of Columbus snowballing. Tonight we're learning hundreds of thousands more people's personal information could be on the dark web. It comes just days after Columbus Mayor Andrew Ginther admitted for the first time that personal information of Columbus residents had been leaked. Good to see you at 6. I'm Andrew Kinsey.
And I'm Yolanda Harris. 10TV's Lacey Chris was the first reporter to break this story in July, and we've been pushing city leaders for weeks now trying to get you answers. Tonight, Lacey is learning new information about who can be a part of this class action lawsuit, and she joins us now live from City Hall. Lacey?
Well, one lawsuit has been filed and more are expected, but many are wondering if they sign up for the free credit monitoring offered by the city, can they still join a lawsuit?
You know, ultimately, I'm the mayor. The buck stops with me, and I take responsibility for information that I've shared with the public.
On Saturday, Columbus Mayor Andrew Ginther admitted the cyber attack was far worse than he said just days before. He announced the city will offer free credit monitoring to anyone who is concerned their private information is now on the dark web. When asked on Saturday if you sign up for the city's credit monitoring, if that means you also give up your rights to sue the city for damages, City Attorney Klein responded,
Cooper Elliott and Meyer Wilson have expanded their class action lawsuit to cover everyone affected by this. Does signing up for that Experian product prevent them from joining that lawsuit?
You know, that's a question for Cooper and Elliott.
We asked for clarification from his office today and were sent this statement. No, the city of Columbus is not attempting to disqualify anyone from seeking to join the lawsuit by providing this free credit monitoring service. Rather, the purpose is to offer immediate security, protection, and peace of mind.
Providing credit monitoring services is something that is a very common part, not the entirety of, but a part of the relief that people get in these data breach cases.
Attorney Michael Boyle works for Cooper Elliott, the law firm that filed a class action lawsuit against the city. The lawsuit initially was brought by two unnamed Columbus police officers and covered all current and former employees. On Friday, the law firm expanded the class action to include anyone who's been impacted by the breach.
You're just covered. So the way class actions work is you file the case and you have a definition of who's included in it.
Boyle explains they are in the early stages in the legal process and hope to meet with city attorneys in the next week or so, hoping to get a better idea of just how many and who has been impacted.
This is not the largest data breach that's been out there. I think this is pretty close to maybe the most severe in terms of the information that has been the nature of the information that's been released.
So class action lawsuits typically take quite a bit of time to hear. Now, if more lawsuits are filed, a judge could try to hear them all together. Boyle tells me he has not decided yet how much relief he'll ask the city for. Reporting live, Lacey Crisp, 10TV News.